Hey guys, my name is Cole James. In case you don't know me, I have a passion to help people with grief and loss and train others to help people with grief and loss. I was just on a call with this great gentleman. He battled with alcohol and is now 3 years sober, got his family back, got his wife back, got his son back, and I was just so inspired by his story. But what happened is he's leading this thing called Celebrate Recovery in his church, and it's basically a Christian-based 12-step program for people dealing with addiction, alcohol, drugs, gambling. I think they cover pretty much most topics. And what he was realizing, again, how cool is it that he does the work to help himself and then wants to pay it forward and help others, right? So I already know this guy's just the right fit for looking in our work too, so I'm excited about that. But anyway, he realized once he got into this work helping others with their addiction, he said, Cole, it's really all about grief. And it was like this light bulb moment, and I was like, yes, yeah, it is all about grief. Grief is the most underrated human experience on the planet. Now, I know you're saying, whoa, whoa, whoa. When it's your grief, you don't feel that way, right? You're very clear on how powerful that experience is, that grief. But what I'm saying is the aftermath of grief and how it affects our society is the most underrated human experience there is, right? People simply don't give it the credit that it needs, which is unresolved grief is causing massive, massive problems in our society, in our friends and family's lives, in our lives. And it's kind of one of my jobs when I wake up every morning is to just scream from the mountaintops at all the people out there that we need to start looking at our grief and our unresolved grief from the past. And so when this great guy is working with all these people on their addictions, he's realizing that most of them got started with a whole list of unresolved losses, and society didn't have any advice for them on how to deal with that. Right? And so they went and found something that could numb the pain, the emotional pain around unresolved grief. Grief is about the conflicting feelings caused by the end of or change in a familiar pattern of behavior. That includes positive life events as well. Everyone in these classes, getting sober, they're going to get a lot of pats on the back from society around getting sober and changing their lives for the positive, and that's great. What they're not going to get are the people like me and this gentleman talking about, you know what, we're really excited for you and really proud of you for taking this step, but it's also a massive change in what you're familiar with, and that's grief. You're grieving the loss of this thing that you relied upon for a long time, and we can look at that too, okay? And we need to look at that because it's really hard to stay sober. As someone who's sober myself, it's really hard to stay sober with a whole pile of emotional pain that you haven't resolved, okay? And so what we find is people in recovery of all different sorts, once they get a good, stable platform on their recovery, their addiction, this is a great next step to look at, is go look at the past hurts, the past grief that maybe got you down this road in the first place. And I've seen thousands of people in recovery have this be a key component of their recovery. So check us out. We have a 90-day challenge. You don't even have to leave your living room. It's once a week for 90 days. And we're gonna go through the grief recovery method. We're gonna help you work on a loss that you will identify as something that is painful for you, that you feel unfinished with. We're gonna give you tools that you can use for the rest of your life. You're gonna meet other amazing people in that group. You will not be analyzed, judged, minimized. Whatever grief you bring, we understand that is grief at 100% of what that unique relationship was for you. There's no pecking order in our work, okay? There's no, this grief is more than that grief. If you come here with a broken heart, we will help you, and we will ensure that everyone else in that group will help you. You will not be sharing anything personal on a group level. You'll be in very small groups when it comes time to share some of that intimate stuff from our lives. It will be probably the safest place you've ever been, okay? And we take pride in that. You'll also be instructed by one of the best facilitators in the world. So anyway, check that out. We have one starting up in a couple of weeks here in November. And then we're gonna have one going every month as well. So this is an online group program where you're gonna sign up and you're gonna show up 2 hours each week for 90 days. So there's massive, massive growth there. Well, do I qualify for a call? Yeah, if you've lived on this planet and are over 18 years old, you have a bunch of grief in your life. We will teach you and we will help you discover some of it that maybe you didn't look at it as grief, but I assure you it's grief, and we know how to help you move past the pain around that stuff. So that's really the main benefit we can give you is a whole framework and tools to help you as new grief comes up. Get complete with old grief that may be weighing you down, holding you back, inhibiting you from achieving dreams you want to achieve. So anyway, book a call with me if you have any questions. I'm here to explain this stuff to you. Like I said, I live this stuff. I dream about this stuff. I wake up wanting to tell more and more people. Grief is a massive, massive underlying issue in all of the hurt in our society. We have to start giving credit where credit is due. We can do something about it, okay? But all of these things we're struggling with as society, there's a key component is grief. That's what this guy found out. He got into helping people over and over and over and seeing all these different stories, and he could put it together, right? And that's what I want to do for you is help you put it together. Look at your unresolved pain, okay? You can call it whatever you want, but a lot of it is unresolved grief, okay? And then look how you can address it, okay? Because you owe it to you to do that. Thank you. And again, reach out to me if you have any questions.